Obama's full of shit. I mean, that's the other thing we need to talk about. With the Defense of Marriage Act and gay marriage or whatever, this guy didn't support gay marriage until like so 3 months before the election, the re-election or whatever. I supported gay marriage for like 10 years before the Democratic nominee for president supported gay marriage. That guy is full of shit.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to A Conversation with Colin. I'm Greg, and this is my roommate, Colin. Now, sometimes Colin says crazy stuff. So every Tuesday and Thursday, I reach into my random topic pile, pull one out, throw it at him, and we talk it out for your amusement. If you like that, like the video, subscribe to our channel, share it with your friends. Colin, are you ready? Today's topic of conversation is immigration, submitted by everyone. Everyone wants to hear your thoughts on this. This is a big deal right about now. So what's going on with the immigrants, the immigrations? All these French people want to come here and live
there's
here.
There's so many French people in this country, I can't even believe it. This is a tough topic.
Yeah, you can come at it whatever direction you want.
All right, so my party has a pretty
Republican Party
has a pretty strict no illegal immigrant platform.
No illegal immigrants.
Right.
Yeah.
And I understand that platform very much.
Okay.
I think illegal immigration is wrong and it's a crime. And if you came here illegally, you're wrong for doing it.
Sure.
And you don't have any right to be here, and you have really no like rights within the greater federal system to like get, you know, welfare or housing or anything like that, which some people enjoy and they shouldn't. Mm-hmm. It's wrong.
Okay.
With that said, we've let it go for so long, since the 80s, the last time we really dealt with this in a major comprehensive way, when we actually gave amnesty to millions of people, which a lot of people don't know, that we've let it go for so long that it's become a huge problem that we can't take care of effectively in terms of human rights by, say, expelling everyone.
Sure.
Right? Like, you can't do that. It's just like not the way we operate as a country. We're like not a totalitarian, like brutal dictatorship where like we do that to people.
Are you saying? You're talking about a grandfather clause here?
No, I think I think the approach to this is like very simple, and
here it comes.
It requires cooperation between both sides, because one side, the Democrats, want to buy a permanent majority by making all of the immigrants legal. Now let's not mix it up at all. Like, the Democrats do not care about these people. They don't care about them.
Okay.
They want to win in posterity.
Future seats.
Future gains voting. Very similar, but much bigger and more important than the Republicans secured with the Cubans when Castro came to power, right?
Okay.
Cuban Americans, until very recently, were a hardcore Republican as a legacy of what the Republicans did for them when the communists took over Cuba, right? Mm-hmm. There's a legacy thing there. And that happens over and over again. It's the same reason why black people voted Republican for generations, is because of Lincoln. It wasn't necessarily because of like what the Republican Party was doing for them after that. It was because Lincoln freed them, defeated the Confederates, and then occupied the South to make sure they can vote and live.
Gotcha.
You know? And like, that's something that they didn't forget. Mm-hmm. Now, this happens over and over and over again in American history. And I think the largely Hispanic illegal immigration population is being taken advantage of by the Democrats, really in a shameless way, by saying that like, we'll give you a way in and we're doing it because it's the human rights thing. It's not, they don't care about that. They like don't care. They want to secure cheap labor for business interests that fund their campaigns, period. And they want to secure a permanent majority at the federal level in elections, period. That was the idea. And I don't want to disparage only them, because Bush tried to do it
sure
in 2005 and 2006 with the Republicans, in which the Republicans still controlled the House and the Senate until 2006, and that failed. So here's the solution.
Here it comes.
The Democrats just passed a bill in the Senate that has no prayer of passing the House, so I'm not even worried about it. But
didn't even know about it, won't ever read about it.
In that bill, which is like 1,100 pages long, like absurd. I don't even know who writes this shit and like why. Like, why this can't be a few pages, no one knows. It basically gives illegal immigrants legal status and a pathway to citizenship.
Okay.
Now, I agree with half of that. I think that like it would be okay for us to say, you don't have to hide anymore. We're not going to arrest you for being here anymore. You know?
Yeah.
You can come out of the shadows. We'll give you a driver's license. We'll give you legal status. You know? We'll take care of like your kids. They can go to school and all these things. But you will never be a citizen of this country. You know?
Oh, interesting.
Now, to me, that says like, you don't have to run and hide. You don't have to hide. Like, you can come out of the shadows and go to the supermarket and have friends and like, you know, like leave this community, this insular community.
Yeah.
But you can never vote. you can never have Social Security or Medicare, you know? And if you want those things, you can leave and come back.
The right way, right. The legal way.
So you have your choice, right? You can either say, like, you can. There's two choices. Either of them, it's totally up to you, you know? You came here illegally, you shouldn't have done it, we can't really do anything about it now, so just come out of the shadows, register, get your driver's license, do all those kinds of things. You can never become a citizen of this country. Or you're free to leave and get back to the back of the line in the country in which you came from and come in the legal way. And that's basically it, you know? I don't understand, like, why we can't meet in the middle ground like this.
Oh, it's because it's politics. That's not how this works.
You can pay taxes, yeah. You can do all those things, but you can't vote, you know?
Do you have to pay taxes?
Yes, if you work, you're going to have to pay taxes. This is a whole other issue, but this is why we should have a consumption tax in this country and not the fair tax, as they call it, and not an income tax. Because then the things you buy are taxed, not the money you make. Mm-hmm. And then this wouldn't even be an issue at all. But, there's shameless politics being played on the Democratic side with this issue in terms of securing it. Like, everyone's like, the Republican Party's in an existential problem, and they probably are, if this doesn't pass. But, like, we shouldn't be passing things because we're worried about politics. We should be passing things because we're principled, you know? And if the Republican Party needs to die, much like the Whigs took over the Republicans in the 1850s, then that's the way it needs to happen. You know what I mean?
Never going to happen.
Well, it certainly can happen.
It can happen, sure. It won't. Politics are fucked, and they're never getting any better. That's the Greg Miller bottom line, a conversation with Greg Miller.
Yeah, I mean,
it's all fucked up. It's all screwed up. Everybody knows it. We don't do anything about it. We're going to keep re-electing and electing new people, but they'll keep being the same old problems.
Yeah, I guess. Like,
Obama's all hope, but then everything still sucks.
Obama's full of shit. I mean, that's the other thing we need to talk about. With the Defense of Marriage Act and gay marriage or whatever, this guy didn't support gay marriage until like 3 months before the election, the re-election or whatever. I supported gay marriage for like 10 years before the Democratic nominee for president supported gay marriage. That guy is full of shit.
You should have run.
And I am like so sick of people acting like he's a great champion of civil rights and human rights. No, he's not. You know? He was against gay marriage when he ran for president and during his entire first term until Joe Biden, like you said, shit the bed on Meet the Press. You know? And then it forced his hand and made him do it before he was ready to do it. Let's not act like Barack Obama is a great champion of freedom and a great champion of civil rights because he's not. You know? He is a politician just like most of the other people in Washington, and they're using this entire group of people who happen to be poor and disproportionately poor and underprivileged to say, like, we'll just make you citizens and give you all the rights and privileges of a citizenship, and they don't really care about that, and they don't care about what it will do to the job market or what it will do to Medicare or Social Security. What they care about is getting votes and permanent majorities at the federal level and making the Republican Party a regional party, which is it will be. You know? Because let's not forget that the Republicans didn't have a majority in the House for like 40-something years. They were a regional party, you know? We sent a few people like Nixon and Reagan to the White House, but by and large, federal politics were dictated by liberals. And I just think the right thing to do for the law-abiding people that come to this country the right way is to not reward the people that didn't. It's not right. That is the principled stand.
That's a good point.
You know what I mean? There are people that wait for years to get to this country legally. Yeah. They pay a ton of money to get to this country legally. They didn't sneak in and then because of the volume of people here, be like, well, you can just stay now, and we'll give you citizenship. I understand that we can't just round people up, and we shouldn't just round people up and deport them.
Right.
And it's okay to say, like, we're not going to do that to you anymore. But, like, you can never be a citizen of this country. Like, that seems, like, totally reasonable to me. And if we really want to nip the problem in the bud, we should amend the Constitution to get rid of birthright citizenship, too, because that would take a whole lot of, that would remove half of the problem.
Is that even a discussion?
It is frankly on the right wing of the Republican Party, but it's not like something that's openly discussed simply because constitutional amendments are so hard to pass.
Sure.
You know, but like birthright citizenship has removed our ability to remove people from the country when the problem wasn't as big, because people were rooted through their American citizen kids that they had here when they weren't here legally.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? So like, this is a problem that's tough. It's a tough problem. Some people think it's, you know, it's too tough to deal with. Some people think that, you know, we need to keep the status quo. Some people think we need to arm the borders and secure the borders. I think securing the borders obviously makes a lot of sense. But why not just like uphold the rule of law in this country that is predicated on the rule of law? If you're here illegally, you shouldn't be. But since the problem is the inundation so high, like just let them stay and let them enjoy some of the rights of American citizenship without giving them citizenship and giving them the right to vote, and give them the option to say, like, if you want to become a citizen, we appreciate that. We're not going to stop you from doing it, but you can't just cut in front of all the people from all corners of the world trying to get into this country.
Yeah.
You know, from Eastern Europe, from Africa, from, you know, all sorts of places. Yeah. It's insane. It's not fair. You know?
It's a lot like how the PlayStation Network's free for everybody, but if you pay for PlayStation Plus, you get a lot of cool stuff.
That's not probably not like that at all, actually.
Probably how they built it.
I don't know. This is. I understand why people are emotional about this. I just think like this is a hill worth dying on, for the Republican Party. Like mm-hmm. I think that like in posterity, people will look at this as being like this wasn't giving citizenship to people that came here illegally is not right. There's a sympathetic way to have dealt with this problem, and they're not dealing with it in a way that makes any sense except politically, and history's not going to smile on that, you know?
Yeah.
History is going to smile on the people that, like, took principled stand in social issues like gay marriage. You know, people are going to appreciate that. Like, there's a wrong side of history on that, right?
Yeah, yeah.
There's not a wrong... There's, like... I don't think that the side that seems right for immigration is going to be the side that's going to be right in when you look at it in historicity. You
know what
I
mean?
So, I don't know. That's mm-hmm. it.
Well, that was a good conversation, everyone. Thank you for non-stop tweeting and talking about that in the comments of these videos. Ladies and gentlemen, what would you like to see Colin talk about? Make sure you leave it in the comments below. You could be on a future episode alongside us. Then make sure you like the video, share it with your friends, subscribe to us here on YouTube. Until next Tuesday or Thursday, have a conversational day. You think we'll be doing conversations with Colin when you have a kid?
I'll do whatever the fuck I want when I have kids. No. How's that?